And if we observe the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and those that were around him, his companions, his family members, and those who followed his example after them, we see that they took extreme care for how they spent their time. Abu Hurairah narrates to us in a hadith, authentic hadith, that he was sitting with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a group of companions sitting with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Abu Hurairah says, in that one particular jalsa, in that one particular gathering and sitting, I counted the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam seeking repentance from Allah, begging Allah for forgiveness 70 times in that one sitting. Imagine just sitting for a few minutes with your friends and you are able to seek repentance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from your sins 70 times. Now what does that tell us? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is having a casual sitting with his companions. They're having a conversation, talking about whatever is important for them at that time. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not speak every single minute. He spoke and he listened. And if there was a part of the conversation that he did not feel benefit to participate in, he didn't just sit with his mouth closed. He sat making istighfar and dhikr. And subhanAllah, I witnessed this in the past few months, sitting at the feet of some of our teachers and scholars. They'll be sitting teaching a class on their chair. And while a questioner is asking a question, or while someone is setting up the microphone, whatever is happening around them, you can hear them whispering, La ilaha illallah, subhanallah, alhamdulillah, astaghfirullah, Allahumma inni astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk, La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu minadh dhalimin. Making use of every single second. Why? What motivates them to act that way? What it is having what I like to call an akhirah mindset. Yes, you're alive in this dunya, but your mind is focusing on the akhirah. And when your mind is focusing on the akhirah, then you look at every single movement of the second hand as a chance for you to get closer to Jannah and further away from hellfire. That's the akhirah mindset. Making use of every single second. And that's why they're able to make this a habit. And that's why the Prophet ﷺ said, make sure your tongue is ratib, wet with the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Always making dhikr. You know, I was looking up some statistics while I was preparing this here. And I'll share some more later on, but this one just came to mind. That the average American, and this statistic is from 2009, so I don't know how the traffic signals have changed since then. But the average American spends 8 hours of their lifetime sitting at red lights. Average lifespan, you would have spent 8 hours sitting at a red light. If you add up all the minutes and seconds you were sitting at a red light. Imagine meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and having 8 extra hours of tasbih, tahleel, istighfar. Imagine with every single istighfar that you made for those 8 hours, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dropped one sin from your record and gave you a reward. And that reward is multiplied and multiplied and multiplied and multiplied because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most generous with the reward. Just sitting at a red light. That's the akhirah mindset. Taking use of every single second.